This is the third part of Find Replace. First part we saw navigation pane, second part we saw the Find Replace dialog, and in this video we are going to focus on searching and replacing for formatting. Alright, so those are base options. Now let's look at something more interesting. Well, those are called formatting. There are lots of course, Word is full of formatting options. So obviously, we would like to search for formatting. But what exactly in formatting? Many people have never clicked on that button and they don't know what they're missing. So before we go into this formatting stuff, it is important to make sure you have hidden characters shown. Shift Control 8 is the shortcut, or you can click on the button which looks like a PA. That's the paragraph character actually. Never mind. What does it do? It shows you things which are normally not seen, like space becomes a dot, tab becomes an arrow, and so on. Now, what means what? You should know. So go to File, Options, Display. It actually tells you this is the type of character and this is how it looks when you enable hidden characters. For troubleshooting, for understanding, for search replace, enabling hidden characters is a really good thing. So keep using this shot. One of the common scenarios is I want to change the formatting across the board. And one of the most common places where you need it is when you want to use style. Many people don't know what are styles, first of all. That's a bad idea. I have a separate video on that. Bottom line, if you're creating a Word document, all headings must be using heading 1 style, heading 2 style, heading 3, like that. Then becomes very easy. But suppose I have old document, I have manually formatted heading 1, heading 2. Now what do? I have to select each one of them and manually apply heading? No, that's not a good idea. So I click on one of them and say select text with similar formatting. Automatically, internally, it uses the find feature and finds all the text which looks similar. And now in one stroke, I can apply heading. That's the idea. Now, how is this happening behind the scenes? Let's look at it. When you go to the formatting option, it shows you all kinds of formatting like font, paragraph, styles, and so on. So if you want to search for, let's say, a particular font and then replace it with a particular font, this is what you do. Language is another interesting one. If you work across countries, then you will have same document with multiple languages in it. So quickly identifying a particular language can be done from here. Probably the most important part here is highlights. I have a separate video for that. But if you want to search for all the places in the document which are highlighted, use the highlight part. So that's about formatting. Remember, usually we have two scenarios. Either we are just finding and looking, or we are finding something and replacing it with something. So keep that in mind. And because find replace can get very complex, we have some very special cases. That special button is really special. Now click in the find area and now click on special. You see a long scary list. Don't get worried, I'll explain. But the important thing to remember is now I'm clicking in the replace text box and clicking on the special. The list changed a little. So what you can find is different, what you can replace is different. That is the first thing to understand. Now let's look at some special situations. So here is a document where there are paragraphs. We can see the paragraph marks because I have enabled the hidden characters. But sometimes there is one paragraph mark, sometimes there are enter. Very common problem. I want to keep one paragraph mark between two paragraphs. So how do you get rid of that? So let's say I have two paragraphs and I want to replace them with one paragraph. Go to find, click on special, and there is paragraph mark. So get used to these. These special characters have a caret sign followed by a character. So caret sign P means paragraph mark. Next time onwards, remember. So I'm saying caret sign P, P twice means two paragraph marks. I want to replace with one. So that gets rid of that problem. Now if you have more than 2, 3, 4, that's a wildcard situation. But here, simple search replace works. Good. There's another problem. Sometimes it is one paragraph but new line. So here is an example. It looks like I have multiple paragraphs. But if I apply the style, hoping that it will be applied only to one line, the style gets applied to all of them. Why? Because look at the character. This is not a paragraph character. This is a something called soft enter or line break. Means line is different, paragraph is same. So now you can search for that manual line break and replace it with actual paragraph mark. That solves the problem. There's another one. We get data with tabs in it. So I have one column, tab, second column, tab, third column. Now if I get many rows like that, I can use convert text to table to make a nice table out of it. The problem is, sometimes there is one tab, sometimes there are two tabs, sometimes there are three tabs. Some people have put tab followed by spaces. Now what do I do? Convert text to table is not going to work, isn't it? I'm sure you have suffered like this and you have manually gone and cleaned up. No, this is where the question is. Search for what? White space. Remember white space? So all of them are treated as white space, whether it is one tab or 17 tabs, it's one white space. And then replace it with the real tab, caret 90, amazing stuff. Data cleanup at its best. And now I can convert text to table in 3 clicks. See the power? This is there for 30 years, by the way. Another amazing feature is I want to search for something. Let's say I am writing creating a brochure and my product name is there. Let's say my product name is Efficiency 365. I have written it multiple places. Now I realize that Efficiency 365 should look different. So I want to make the word Efficiency 365 bold and red. Now what will I do? I have to go and find each one of them, then select and then bold and no. So what do I do? I search for Efficiency 365. So find that in the replace one. What do I do? In replace, there is a special thing called find what. Yes, means what? Whatever has been there written in find what, put it there. Then what's the point? I'm finding the same thing, putting the same thing. No. Now you go to format and change the font to bold and red. And now in replace all, one stroke, you will change all instances of your brand name to a better looking brand name. Isn't that beautiful and powerful? Another completely out of the world scenario. Here is the text, sample text we have been using for a long time. A quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. Now the word dog has come so many times. Why should I use the word dog? Why can't I show a picture of a dog? So let me put a picture first. But this picture is a picture. Now, am I really going to delete the word dog and copy paste the picture 20 times? No. So what will I do? I'll put the picture in the text once. Then cut the picture. So now the picture is in clipboard. Now I'll go to find replace. Why would I go to find replace? Well, because I'll search for the word dog. And in replace, there is a special thing called whatever is in clipboard, replace with that. And now in few clicks, I have a much more visual item. Isn't that amazing? But wait, this looks like a scenario for a children's book. No, this is very useful in user manuals because very often we describe something and then we want to replace it with either the UI element or a physical button on a device. Now talking about books, do you know I have written a book recently about how exactly to use Microsoft 365 platform. The link is in the description. It covers 27 apps and 130 best practices. Just blindly follow them and you will revolutionize your efficiency. So that, in a nutshell, is how you use find replace in Word. Remember, this is not a complete topic. The wildcard part is the most powerful part. I have no doubt that this was useful to you. And I have absolutely no doubt that you are going to subscribe, like, share and comment. If I miss something, put it, I will cover that as well. If you have a question, something is not working as expected, put that as well. And before you go, look at the wildcard search part as well. It's not equally, it's more powerful than what we have covered. So that's it for now. The search for search ends here. Take care.